Inadequate sanitation contributes worldwide to the death of at least 1.5 million children under the age of 5 annually. Why is it extremely difficult to give access to the urban poor to sanitation facilities? In this video, I will explain why a lack of sanitation is not just bringing more toilets to the urban slums, but that access to sanitation is closely related to a decision-making process where stakeholder involvement plays a crucial role. An example is Katanga Village, one of the informal settlements in Kampala where the urban poor are living. In Katanga, sanitation is one of the biggest health and environmental problems. To improve the sanitation facilities, technical experts decided to install several EcoSan toilet blocks in Katanga. This seems to be an attractive solution as EcoSan toilets protect public health, prevent pollution, and return nutrients to the soil. Yet, in Katanga slum, the EcoSan toilets are fully ignored because the potential users are convinced that these toilets are not hygienic. The decision to introduce EcoSan toilets was made by experts, based on technical and environmental motives, not taking into account daily lifestyles, religious beliefs, cultural habits, or economic capacity. Its failure underlines the necessity of co-decision making between experts and users in the process of developing and implementing sanitation facilities. But how can these potential users be involved in the decision-making process? PROACT is a decision-making method that matches very well with a stakeholder dialogue. The PROACT method consists of 5 phases: problem analysis, setting of objectives, selection of alternatives, assessment of the consequences, and trade-offs between different alternatives. Let's have a closer look to these 5 phases. The problem analysis phase focuses on the identification of the problem. Scientists, experts, policymakers, and users need to develop a common understanding of the problem, of the decision that has to be made, and of the criteria by which such decisions will be judged and evaluated. The people living in the slums are, for example, afraid that their children got ill, as the experts recognize polluted water as the main problem. The objectives are set by all stakeholder groups involved to reach a common understanding of the problem. It is important that all stakeholders have the opportunity to actively participate in this phase. By doing so, the different perspectives and points of view in the process are collected. After the phases of problem analysis and the setting of objectives, sanitation experts, having the context and the criteria that are formulated by all stakeholder groups in mind, are coming up with a selection of feasible alternatives. During this phase, scientists and experts on sanitation are much better equipped to determine the feasible options in a given context. All alternatives are screened by the potential users, who are assessing the consequences for each of them. First, the users discuss with each other the pros and cons of each alternative. Participants listen to each other's arguments and preferences. Afterwards, they screen individually on the criteria they set together in the phase of setting the objectives. The criteria often consist of indications for technical feasibility, cost-effectiveness, and social, health, and environmental impact. In the trade-off phase, these alternatives are ranked in the order of preference and scored against the criteria that were set in an earlier phase. Each of these criteria has been assigned a particular weight within the final decision-making process as a reflection of their relative importance. The weight and the scores on the criteria are combined for each alternative to derive their overall value. For policymakers, this will lead to a better understanding of the positive and negative commitment of users for certain options. Finally, the best alternative can be determined. Because PROACT combines the information, knowledge, and experiences from experts, policymakers, and users, it balances all different inputs to make sure that none dominates. It excludes stakeholder groups from phases where they have little to contribute. This makes the participatory decision-making process more efficient and feasible. In this video, I showed that using PROACT can lead to substantial improvements in decision-making in the field of sanitation in slum areas.